I promise you that after watching this video, you will grease every single landing. Here's how I do it, and it works every time. Hey everyone, and welcome back to the Mile High Nomads. Today, we're talking about one of the most rewarding and sometimes frustrating parts of flying, the landing. We've all had those landings that make us feel like airline captains, and others that make us just want to sink into the seat. So today, I'll show you exactly how to nail your landing every time using a stabilized approach, proper roundout, smooth flare, and controlled rollout. Every perfect landing starts with a stabilized approach. That means you have a constant airspeed, a constant rate of descent, and you're aligned with the runway centerline. Also, you want to be using an aiming point. This is the point on the runway that when you're on a stable approach, this point is in the middle of your windscreen and is not moving. When you are at a constant airspeed and descent rate, there will be one point in the window from which everything else around it kind of expands. For most training aircraft, like a Cessna 172, the constant airspeed you want to maintain is about 65 knots on final. At that speed, you got full control, enough energy for a smooth flare, and you're not carrying any extra speed that'll cause you to float by staying in ground effect for too long. For the descent rate, a good rule of thumb is roughly 1,000 feet of descent for every 3 nautical miles you fly. That gives you about a 3-degree glide path, which is what most visual and instrument approaches are based on. Now, use power to control your glide path and pitch to control your speed. Trim is key in this phase. Trim the airplane for 65 knots and control your altitude to stay on glide path with your throttle. If you're high, reduce power slightly. If you're low, add a touch. And once you're trimmed and stable, focus on your aiming point and just maintain that steady picture all the way down to the threshold. If you're stable by about 500 feet AGL, meaning 65 knots, proper descent rate, and centerline alignment, you're setting yourself up for a smooth landing. If not, go-arounds are always an option. As you cross the threshold at approximately 100 feet before your aiming point, you start your roundout. I like to do this when I see the stride before my aiming point start to disappear under the cowling. This is where you begin to transition from descent to level flight. Think of it as pausing your descent while keeping the airplane just above the surface. Shift your eyes from your aiming point to the far end of the runway. That's key. Looking farther ahead really helps your brain judge height and depth. Smoothly raise the nose to stop the descent. Not too much, just enough to fly a few feet above the runway. Now comes the flare, the art of holding the airplane off the ground until it's ready to land by bleeding out the leftover energy of the wings. As your airspeed reduces, gently add progressive back pressure on the yoke. You're not pulling to make it land, you're pulling to keep it flying just above the runway as the wings lose their lift. If you do it right, the main wheels will touch down softly at a nose-high attitude with a stall horn just beginning to yell at you. If you're too early with the flare or with too much airspeed, you'll balloon. But too late, with only little airspeed, you'll plant it straight down on the runway. But with practice and consistent airspeed, you start to feel exactly when the airplane wants to settle. Now for touchdown, you want the longitudinal axis of the airplane aligned with and over the centerline of the runway. Most of the hard landings aren't a result of a too high drop. These planes can handle a drop of a few feet as long as the plane is aligned with the centerline. But when you land out of alignment, you will put too much sideways pressure on the landing gear. And because of the fact the plane instantly wants to correct to straight after touchdown, it will feel like you and your passengers get thrown either to the left or right, which makes it feel like a very, very rough landing. During the rollout and once the mains are on the ground, keep flying the airplane. Hold back that pressure on the yoke to keep the nose wheel light and use rudder to stay straight on that center line. As your speed drops, gently let the nose wheel come down on its own. You don't want to derotate the plane by pushing forward. After the nose wheel touches down, smoothly apply brakes as needed. Calm, controlled, and ride down the center line. Avoid conversations with ATC until you are clear of the runway. Cross the hold short line completely, do your after landings checklist, and taxi safely to the tie down with proper wind corrections. If you find this helpful, I would recommend watching this video about how you can keep the plane coordinated and aligned with its centerline during landing. And also, I explain why the plane has the tendency to yaw during landings and takeoffs. Apply these tips to grease every landing. Hit that like button, subscribe for more flying lessons and adventures. And let me know in the comments what's your best landing tip. Thank you for watching and fly safe.